Hi. About a week ago, my girlfriend and I broke up. Basically, I had two options. Get on the bottle and start swiping right, or do something stupid. Naturally, I chose the latter option. So I set myself a challenge. Basically, no hiking or trekking experience. I've given myself 40 days to prepare for an 18-day, completely solo trek to Everest Base Camp in the Gyoko Lakes. Now to achieve this, based on no research whatsoever, I've come up with a foolproof three-step plan. Over the next 40 days, I will focus on
diet.
Hi there, welcome to McDonald's. How can I help you?
Exercise.
And altitude training. This is my first hurdle. However, I've come up with an ingenious fix. I understand at these altitudes, I will have less oxygen, therefore I need bigger lungs, therefore I need bigger chest, and with a slight change to my training schedule, I should be all sorted. One thing I'm forgetting. Oh, a travel beard.
Way you do it.
So I survived what's been described as the world's dangerous flight, so I think I need to give this prayer with a spin. Today was tough. It's definitely starting to notice the lack of oxygen, but tomorrow should be a lot easier because I've got 5 kilos of calculators here that's going to go up to Sir Ed's school that he set up.
like a part of me that only I can see. You're even with me when I'm all alone. The people stop and stare, they say that no one's there. Maybe we're better when we're on our own. They don't know.
The last 2 days can only be described as the worst 2 days of my life. Ended up getting gastro, which at 4,500 meters is not an enjoyable experience. I seriously thought I was gonna die, and so did the two people looking after me, and they wanted to get a rescue helicopter up to come get me. But 2 days later, feeling 100% again. So what doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Never seen, but they don't believe in us. And you are.
As you can see, there's pretty much no visibility, and I'm just camped out in this cave for a bit because the path has completely disappeared. And I have no idea where I am or where I'm meant to go, but life is good.
It's crazy how quickly the weather changes here. It was gone from the worst storm ever to the most beautiful day you'll ever see. Check out the scenery.
I'll take you anywhere, I'll go anywhere. I'll take you anywhere, I'll go anywhere. I'll take you
past 5,000 meters, and today we're heading up to Everest Base Camp. So after spewing my guts out at 3,500 meters, wherever it was, I did not think I was going to make it this far. But got a splitting headache, and blood's coming out of my nose, and I'm coughing up blood. But life is good.
Day's trekking in freezing conditions, nothing quite beats coming home to a nice hot towelette.
Yesterday is not today, I know that I won't get another chance. No looking back, the time is gone, we turn the page, the past is in the past. Why don't